hit me up. She's back in Michigan. She just is like, Detroit is just devastated right now. Like the whole city's just crushed.
And let's not forget her cute scene and the Blues Brothers as well. Great scene.
I forgot about that. Yeah, she did respect in that one, didn't she?
Think
about
now the sequel she did. Respect.
No, but I didn't see the sequel. I was thinking about Think where she was working in the coffee. She was working in the coffee shop.
Yeah, down in Jewtown in Chicago. Like I said, I'm from Chicago, and I wasn't down when they filmed that part. I was down off of Garfield when they filmed Ray Charles scene.
Man, so you go way back on this shit. Thank you for calling up, and I'm glad you're listening to Shay 45, man. I appreciate you.
Yeah, man. Anytime. Hey, keep doing what you're doing, baby. Very proud of you.
Always, bro. Let's go to Benay. Go ahead, man. Oh, is this a woman?
Hey,
Benay.
Hey, yeah.
So how you doing?
I'm quite well. How are you?
I'm good.
Good. So, yeah, I mean, I just wanted to call in because I was actually able to meet Aretha when I was like 14. My dad's in the music industry, and I'm a singer too, and he just kind of told me, like, you know, basically know your worth. If you want to be a female singer in the industry, like, don't let anybody try to take you away from, like, those aspirations. Don't let anyone try to make you show ass and anything crazy like that. She was super down to earth, and she was like a real ass, like, woman for real, like, really for, like, woman empowerment and really for, you know, like, the whole, you know, black queen movement and whatnot. So that was, like, something that they really didn't say about it. They always kind of tried to, like, say she was shady and she didn't really give anyone else props. But it was the complete opposite, at least when I met her. So I wanted to share that with y'all.
And here's the deal, man. Here's the deal. Like, people are human.
Yeah.
People are human. That shit might be right, and your shit might be right, but it doesn't change her body of work and what she did for the culture. So, Cass, appreciate that, and thank you for calling up.
Thank you.
Let's go to Shane in Atlanta. Shane, go ahead.
Hey, Jude, how you doing, man?
Good, bro. What you want to say?
Hey, here's a song my dad turned me on to when I first started getting into good music, but it's on a Dwayne Allman anthology album.
Yeah.
And he personally got a release of Franklin to cover the weight. They were doing a little studio break, everybody took a break. He hung back with Aretha and got her to do a little version of the weight, and he sung that album, man, and it's just something you never thought she would sing, or I'm hearing her sing it, so it's something special to listen to, man, to hear that kind of voice.
That's the other thing. A lot of cats don't realize this shit, too, is back in the 70s, man, you had... What? Go ahead, let's throw it on, and I'll talk a bit over it. You'd have all these great musicians just cross-pollinating, working with one another. He's taken down at the 7 after a gain of 7. I was feeling bad, I had passed it. I just need some place. Just a band cover. Where I can lay my head. Turn it up. Hey, mister, can you tell me where a girl might find a band? Can you tell me? He just leaned and shook my hand. See, like, that's the ill shit. Like, back in the set, man, you would just see these. Like, Donny Hathaway was playing keys on fucking Young, Black, and Gifted. Like, you just would see all of these really gifted musicians playing on each other's shit and making these songs that last. They're not throwaway. They're not disposable. They make songs that last. They hold up. You hear her. You hear her voice. And she was talking, and she was speaking on, like, the woman before, speaking on being a strong black woman. Like, she, Aretha had to go through some shit to be a strong black woman. You know what I mean? Like, she had to really go through some shit in the 60s, even with dealing with men. There's a really cool documentary to check out called Muscle Shoals. She's highlighted in it a bit. it's worth checking out. Let's go to let's keep the sample session going. 888-742-3345. 888-742-3345 is the number to dial. This one is kind of cool, man. This one is Kanye West produced this song. You can just dead it. You know, dead off no music. Kanye West produced this song, and it actually helped blow up an already buzzing underground hip hop group from Detroit called Slum Village, which Dilla did most of the production. Maybe Dilla did the beat on this, but I want to say it's Kanye. But Jay Dilla, of Jay Dilla's fame, he was with a group called Slum Village. Fantastic Volume 2 is a great album. You should really check it out. But this wasn't off of that album. This was their fucking crossover pop hit. And they took Call Me and freaked it a little bit, made it their own thing, and came out with a hit. Here's Aretha Franklin doing Call Me.
Now it's Jackson. And that one going to come up short. Low throw.
Jackson Goody is going to be a very busy guy. Two catches already in this opening drive, and they were looking his way for a third.
I think they put this defense on notice that could be a really, really friendly combination. On third down, Jackson. Throw complete right side to Cooks. And he's going to have a Seahawks first down as they're able to get the third down conversion.
She let the track breathe. And she got on it. She didn't have to over-sing. She just had pipes. Now I'm going to play you Effortless. Now I'm going to play you what Slum Village did with this. This was quite the hit in the early 90s. A lot of cats don't realize Kanye was a fucking backpacker. Like, y'all look at him now. Kanye started off backpacker, rapper, official, dug in the crates, fucking awesome. Like, he checked off every mark of being a true hip-hop fucking, all you backpackers, oh, that's not real hip-hop. Kanye was real fucking hip-hop. He dug in the fucking crates, and he would pair with real hip-hop motherfuckers, and this is him pairing with Slum Village right here, The Selfish. And I want to say this John Legend was on this shit before. He might have had dreadlocks at the time. This is back when John Legend had dreadlocks. Kanye put his ass on. Here it is, a little Selfish. I hope this is the right one. Nope, I don't know. There we go.
I'm falling, baby, I'm selfish. I want you to myself, I can't help it. All my, yeah, baby, I'm selfish. All my ladies and I can't.
I'm selfish. I'm
to my
my thick chicks down in Texas, all the way to New Orleans where the girls could catfish. And in LA, every chick's an actress, Hollywood status with the shade of glasses. To Detroit, yeah, the place that I rest, where the ladies got asses and a lot of sex. And how to let y'all is one of the best, where they speak Southern slang and smoke lot sex. And New York women are way too fresh, too much on your mind, let me ease that stress. I wish you all were mine, it's so selfish. Maybe I'm feeling myself too much, I guess. But to my ladies all across the globe, in small towns that I don't even know, to all local international gold, whether you see me in the streets or catch me at shows, I'm calling.
Now don't be trying to come around my girl acting like Mr. Friendly and steal the spotlight like Mr. Bentley. I spotted her like Spud McKenzie, and for them fake boobies I paid them Benjis. Get your own, I got Paris, he got Nicki, he tried to get him a clone. He said, yeah, you know you got extra hoes and everything you do is extra cold. From the polo fleece to the Jesus piece, I got family in high places like Jesus niece. Can I please say my peace? If y'all fresh to death, then I'm deceased. And this one here is a heat rock, like the beatbox, the way the beat rocks, new version of heat rock. But for that Benz, I get CL love, so I switch my girls around like 3L dub. I'm calling. What up, Pam? How your little man doing in New Jersey? Last I heard, he caught the flu and he was worried. Hope he feels better. And thanks, Jonetta from Cleveland, for that good head and your jet better. But Lizzy Bishop needs you my piece from Compton. Before I'm off the plane, make sure you cop some trees and spark up. Danielle, ATL, got them pictures in the mail. You sealed with a kiss and you sent it with Chanel. You looking good in that one, showing off your body. Had a Beverly Hills mommy that would buy me parties, take me to after parties. Her name was Kari. And it sucks that we didn't keep in touch. I'm sorry, but hey, Kim, how's Minneapolis? You so pretty, hate you show off your titties for silly glasses, cause I love you girls, though you ain't mine. I wish my arms was long enough to hug you all at the same time.
I'm calling, yeah, baby, I'm selfish. I want you to myself, I can't help it.
You know some Detroit shit. He was claiming Cardi A's and shit in the rap. And I just see some Detroit dudes doing well over top of the fucking Detroit artists. Sample. Kanye West. John Legend, Slum Village. Eight at 8-7-4-2-3-3-4-5. If you can't get through and you wanna and you still wanna tell me, like I posted a thing on Aretha Franklin, you could put it on my Instagram at One More Jew. Just click on that shit, or if you wanna tweet me at @Rude_Jude or at All Out Show. 888-742-3345. Dave Hoffman going to lunch, heard that Aretha Franklin sample session on All Out Show. Now I'm gonna eat lunch in the car, not missing this. Fuck with you, dog. I fuck with you, dog. All right, let's go. Oh, we got some inside. Some inside shit on it. Let's go to 9 in Fort Worth, Texas.
Hey, what's good, man? First of all, man, the dude that's facilitating the phone calls, man, he's the real MVP because he's holding it down. But speaking on Aretha Franklin, man, I got a homeboy of mine that actually worked with her. He was the background singer for her, and he would talk about just how much he epitomized the word. Diva. She had to have the temperature at 72 degrees, man, or she wouldn't go out, or she would actually wait until the temperature was that amount before she would go out, man. And also, what she would do for the city of Detroit, man, she still did food drives for him every year, as well as her civil rights movement with Martin Luther King, man. So, you know, her music spans like 6 decades, you know. Think about that for a second, man. So, you know, just the impact that she had on your mother's mother. it's something that a lot of people can't say nowadays, man. And I appreciate you guys for doing it today, man.
Yeah, people often ask me, like, what do you think about this artist? And what do you think about that artist? And it's like, I really don't think much about them. Let's wait 20 years, and then we can discuss it. Let's see how they hold up. Time will tell. Time will fucking tell.
Listen to her sing, man. Her voice is so powerful, man. Like, it's just, you almost take it for granted until she does pass away. Like, man, you know what? I really missed out on something, man. But, man, you know, we still got the music, and like you said, it's timeless.
It's funny you say that, man. It's funny you say that, Nine. It's almost like it gets so popular they start playing it in the fucking grocery store, and you're picking out bread to it, and then you don't really stop and listen. Like, you don't really stop and listen and be like, damn. No, they were really putting it down right here. Like, she really got pipes right here. I find that with, like, Marvin Gaye and shit like that, too, or fucking a lot of classic rock. Like, it's become so popular that we devalue it until they pass. And then you got to go back and listen and be like, God damn, she was on that track.
True story.
She's really doing it. All right, thanks, Don. I appreciate
it. Thank you, man. All right, now.
Steven in North Cackalack. What up, though? I know in every game we do, we talk about momentum. Steve.
That was a momentum play lost, and now
Steve.
There could be a letdown because it didn't get the interception.
Yeah, you can almost hear the collective gasp on the sideline.
888-742-3345. Let's see if I can squeeze a couple more of these motherfucking Unity cats. Here's a very, 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 very popular one. This is probably one of I'll probably say this is probably one of the most famous samples.
Some success. Finally, the defense coordinator found some success of his own.
I think he just simply said enough of that.
By somebody, I think he played like young Sherlock Holmes or some shit like that. He played like a young, he was a child actor turned rapper.
The kick by Lambeau is good.
I'll let you think on that while I play this one step ahead.
They don't get a touchdown here in the opening drive of the third quarter, but I think maybe you still say mission accomplished as they come away with the lead.
No, absolutely. You keep the pressure on. You go downfield, get some points up on the board, and hope that you motivated your defense to take the field and hold that lead.
I'm only one step ahead of heartbreak.
Here the Vikings now to start their next drive. They find themselves down on the scoreboard following the field goal.
One step is all I have to
say. I would consider that a win for their defense. That's probably what they're telling the offense when they get to the bench. Hey, Nona, son, you guys now get back out there and get us the lead back.
So now they have to contend with second and 13 after the first down run goes backwards.
One step ahead of your one kick going from your sweet
lips.
I know I can't afford to stop for one moment, 'cause I'm just out of reach of your
fingertips.
Your umbrella.
Did you get it yet? You figured it out. Did you figure it out?
Yeah. That it's too forget you. It's too late to be free. Can you see?
Right.
I'm only one step back.
Most deaf.
I'm manipulating a defense with their eyes and their.